I hope all of you are fine. Here, now I am going to take the 8th standard SST History Unit 1. Name of the lesson, Advent of the Europeans. Many of the foreign travelers, traders, missionaries and civil servants who come to India in 18th and 19th centuries have left accounts of the experience and the impression of various parts of the country. Sources of modern India. From where we are getting information about the past Indian history. For that, our historians depended many valuable sources. So here we are going to explain. I am going to explain the sources of Indian history. The sources for the history of modern India help us to know political, socio-economic and cultural development in the country from the very beginning. The Europeans recorded their official transaction in India on state papers, and well-preserved records are very valuable to know about the relations in India. The arches of Lisbon, Goa, Pondicherry and Madras are the literary storehouses. These records help the history students to know about the past Indian history. For framing history, historians depended on various kinds of sources. What are the kinds of sources historians depend for framing history? First one, literary sources. Second one, material sources. Written sources are the literary sources. Literature, travel accounts, diaries, autobiographies, pamphlets, government documents, manuscripts and books in different languages. These are the thing came under the category of written sources. Literature, we know the same. Travel account, those who are writing the detailed description about the travel details. Diaries, we are all writing diaries. Okay, autobiographies, pamphlets, government documents. Okay, this is more familiar. The next one, archives. What is this archives? Archives is the place where historical documents are preserved. Archives is the place where historical documents are preserved. So it has main sources of information for understanding past administrative machinery as well as guide to present and future generation. For example, the National Archives of India, NAI, located in New Delhi. Second one, in our Tamil Nadu, the Madras Record Office, TNA, is located in Chennai. From here, we are getting more valuable information about our past. Next one, material sources. What are the material? The name itself, we can understand the meaning. Materials, paintings, statues, coins, historical buildings, etc. are material sources. Buildings like India Gate, Parliament House, President House are best example. Objects and materials of religions are preserved in museum. These promote our cultural heritage. When we are visiting the museum, we know the same. There they are preserving many valuable things. Old type of religious things, then dresses, vessels, weapons, everything they are preserved. So the new generation, they are getting clear information about the same. Next one, coins. Coins are the good sources to know about the administrative history. Most of our ancient coins Kings are inscribed year, name of king, etc. That is very easy for the historians to find out the period of coin. Metal used in the coin shows the prosperity of the kingdom. So coins are the valuable information. Coins are giving more valuable information to the historians. The first paper currency issued by RBI in January 1938 was 5 rupee note, being the portrait of King George VI. All these things are more valuable for the historians to frame the history of modern India. After the capture of Constantinople by the Turks in 1453 AD, the land route between India and Europe was closed amongst the entire European nation. Portugal was the foremost to make a dynamic attempt to discover a sea route to India. Prince Henry of Portugal, who is commonly known as Navigator, encouraged his countrymen to take up the adventurous life of exploring the unknown regions of the world. Bartolomeo Dias, a Portuguese sailor, reached the southernmost point of Africa in 1487. He was patronized by King John II. Another Portuguese sailor reached the southernmost point of Africa and he continued his journey to Mozambique, from where he sailed to India with the help of an Indian pilot. In AD 1498, Vasco da Gama reached Calicut, where he was kindly received by Samarin, the ruler of Calicut. At first, Portuguese and natives are in friendly relationship. Later, it leads to conflicts. Followed by Vasco da Gama, Francisco de Almeida, Alfonso de Albuquerque, Nino de Cunha, etc. came to India. In 1505, Francisco de Almeida was sent as the first governor for the Portuguese possession in India. Almeida had an aim to developing the naval power of Portuguese in India. His policy was known as Blue Water Policy. Alfonso de Albuquerque, the real founder of Portuguese power in India. He captured Goa from the Sultan of Bijapur in November 1510. In 1515, he established the Portuguese authority over Ormuz in Persian Gulf. He encouraged the marriage of Portuguese with Indian women. He maintained friendly relation with Vijayanagar Empire. In 16th century, Portuguese succeeded in capturing Goa Dam and Diu and other parts of India. First, they are giving importance to establishing trading center. Later, they gave importance in territorial interest. So, going to study about the Dutch. Followed by the Portuguese, the Dutch people also came to India. They formed Dutch East India Company. After arriving India, they established the first factory in Masulipatnam. Masulipatnam, that is in present Andhra Pradesh. In 1605, the Dutch captured Portuguese settlement and gave importance for trade. Silk, cotton, indigo, rice and opium are the main commodities. Silk we know, then cotton also we know the same. Indigo means that is a type of color. This Europeans, they are using mostly indigo being only coloring their cloth. Rice also we know the same. Opium is a narcotic purpose only they are using the same. It is a juice of a poppy plant. They monopolize the trade in black pepper. Black pepper also that is more in our India than other spices. Spices also we know the same. Cardamom, pepper, like that way things. Dutch established the factories in Surat, Pulikat, Kasim Bazar, Cochin, etc. So this is a short descriptions about the Dutch. Like Portuguese, Dutch also came to India. At first they are giving more importance for trade. Later they are having some conflict between the native rulers and the Dutch people. Next, after the Dutch people, the British people, they came to India on 31st December 1600 with the permission of Queen Elizabeth of England. Merchant of England trade alliance with India. They are getting some concession from the Mughal king Jahangir. With that privilege, English people established the factory at Surat in 1613. Followed by this, the British established many factories all over India. First, they are giving importance to establishing trading centers, especially factories. They are establishing many factories all over India and they are giving importance for exporting Indian product to Europe. Later, they gave importance in territorial interest. Why they are giving more importance to territorial interest? Because that time in our India, there are small kingdoms only rule all over India. All these ruling kings, they are warring each other for men and money. So this is the golden opportunity for the British people. They are giving importance to acquiring territories in India. Slowly, British people became prominent power in India, Indian soil. They continued till August 15, 1947. We know the same. What is the importance of that date? That is the Independence Day of India. So still that the Britishers, they are continue in Indian soil. So about the war and Congress, we are discussing about the same in next lesson. Next group of people, Danish. On March 17, 1616, the King of Denmark, Christian IV, issued a charter and created a Danish East India Company. They established a settlement at Trankobar, that is in Tamil Nadu, our Tamil Nadu only, in 1620, and Serampore in Bengal in 1676. But they can't able to continue in this settlement more year because of the enmity of English. So the Danish people, they are not continue more days in India. They are somewhat, they are doing something, means some factories or some settlements they are created. But because of the enmity of the English, they can't able to continue the power in India. Next group of people, next we are going to study about French. The French East India Company was formed in 1664 by Colbert, a minister of King Louis the 14th. That time, King Louis only, the ruler of France, he only gave all facilities to found French East India Company with the help of his able minister Colbert. In 1669, they founded factories at Surat and Masulipatnam. In 1673, the settlement was founded in Pondicherry. French East India Company established many factories in coastal regions. Later, French neglected trade and engaged themselves in wars with India and other European power. The war ruined the French power in India and the British became master in India. So that time we know the same. In India, there are many warring states are there. These French and the English, they are making friendly alliances with many of the Indian rulers. So these became a war. There are many wars that commenced in India. Carnatic Wars, Mysore Wars, like that way, many wars. Because of the same, these wars, they ruined the French treasury. So, in Europe, the France position is not in good condition. There are many reasons are there for French, they are became ruined in India. Comparative success of the British over the Portuguese, the Dutch, the Danish and the French was largely due to their commercial competitiveness, spirit of supreme sacrifice, government support, naval superiority, national character and the ascendancy in Europe. So, the Britishers, they are became more prominent in India. They are became the masters of Indian soil. Write about the importance of coins. What are the sources of modern India? Give a short note on archives. Once again, write about the importance of coins. What are the sources of modern India? Give a short note on archives. One more on activity for you. Prepare a chart on the kinds of sources of modern India. Prepare a chart on the kinds of sources of modern India. In that one, you can add the important building, coins or weapons or what are the thing we can see in the museum or picture collection. In scrapbook, you can do the same.